celebrate the culmination of the Easter season on this, the Feast of Pentecost. Jesus gave his apostles the gift of the Holy Spirit and empowered them to carry out his mission. Let us be open during this liturgy to the gifts of the Holy Spirit and pray for the grace and power to renew the face of the earth. Our gathering hymn is Come Holy Ghost. Please stand as we begin our celebration with our priest, Father Alex Roche.
Christ Jesus, who ascended to the right hand of the Father, Christ, have mercy. A reading from the book of the prophet Joel. Thus says the Lord, I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh. Your sons and daughters shall prophesy. Your old men shall dream dreams. Your young men shall see visions. Even upon the servants and the handmaids, in those days I will pour out my spirit, and I will work wonders in the heavens and on the earth, blood, fire, and columns of smoke. The sun will turn to darkness and moon to blood at the coming of the day of the Lord, the great and terrible day. Then everyone shall be rescued who calls on the name of the Lord. For on Mount Zion there shall be a remnant, as the Lord has said, and in Jerusalem survivors whom the Lord shall call. The word of the Lord.
Himself intercedes with inexpressible groanings.
And the one who searches hearts knows what is the intention of the Spirit, because he intercedes for the holy ones according to God's will. The word of the Lord.
Celebration of something that happened once 2,000 years ago. to a bunch of disciples in some upper room. Pentecost is something that's supposed to happen every day. Pentecost is something that is supposed to occur every time any of us receive the Holy Spirit and share it. You see, this Feast of Pentecost really is about more than just the Holy Spirit coming down on the disciples. The second half of this feast day is the way they respond. And right on that same day that he received the gift of the Holy Spirit, Saint Peter goes out and he preaches. And he teaches us how we're supposed to do it. So there's two parts of Peter's preaching that help us figure out how we're supposed to do this. On the one hand, Peter is preaching facts. He is preaching testimony and a witness to certain events that happen. Saint Peter gets up there and he recites to all the people watching all the prophecies that led up to Jesus, including the one from Joel, our first reading of the day. He recounts all the things that Jesus taught him as they walked together for those 3 years. He recounts how Jesus was put to death, how he rose from the dead, and then ascended to the right hand of the Father. You see, it's important at some points to talk about what we believe. For the early Christians, it was something as simple as going around preaching, Jesus is Lord, Jesus is risen. Those concrete facts are important, and they're part of how this story works. But they're not the only thing that Peter did when he stood up there and preached in front of 3,000 people. You see, Peter was also sharing with all of those gathered something subjective. He was also sharing with them an experience. His experience of God. He was sharing with people how it was that God changed his life. And by doing so, inviting them to allow God to change their lives. We don't often think about this as preaching, but it really is. Think about all the different ways you live the gospel in your life. When you go out there and perform some act of kindness or charity for someone, you're not necessarily preaching to them information, but you are forming a relationship with them. You are acting as Christ in their life and inviting them to have a relationship with Christ through you. Think about what happens when you pray for someone. Not necessarily learning anything about God, but you are inviting them to come to know the God that you know, and inviting God to enter into their life. Think about when you come up here at Mass and receive the Eucharist. You're not all of a sudden infused with all sorts of information about who Jesus is or what the Bible says. What happens when you receive the Eucharist is you are entering into a relationship with the Lord that you receive. When you receive the Eucharist, you are having an experience of the living God within you. As we celebrate this Pentecost, as we reflect on what it means to be a church and how it is we're supposed to preach the gospel, it's important for us to always remember those two parts of what Peter does. On the one hand, we can't be afraid to tell people what we believe, to preach the good news of the gospel. That's without question part of it. But it's not the only part of being a Christian. Just as important is sharing with people your experience of God. Sharing with them the ways in which God has changed you and inviting them to allow God to enter into their lives and their hearts. we're talking about as we celebrate Pentecost, as we celebrate the Holy Spirit descending on the people, as we celebrate the birth of the church, is remembering that our faith is about a relationship with our God. And just like any relationship, part of it is learning about God. Just like when you go on a first date, you find out what the other person's favorite color or favorite food is. But it's also getting to know God, experiencing God, and forming a relationship with God. May the Holy Spirit come down on our hearts just like he did at that first Pentecost 2,000 years ago. May the Holy Spirit inspire us to preach the gospel and to share with the world our experience of the God who has changed.
Lord, hear our prayer. For all Christians, that renewed in the Holy Spirit, we may always seek unity as one body in Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the peace the Holy Spirit brings may pervade the entire world, so that nations never again settle their differences by taking up arms against each other, and that local authorities are able to maintain peace without resorting to violence. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who have lost hope, the single parent working two jobs and raising their children, the homeless person living on the streets, the prisoner serving a life sentence, the patients living with chronic illness, that they may be comforted through the work of the Holy Spirit, let us pray to the Lord. For those who were baptized to confirm this Easter season, that they may grow in wisdom and understanding, prudence and courage, knowledge, piety, and awe, let us pray to the Lord. For all our prayers spoken and unspoken, for the sick and homebound, and for all those in our special attention book near our cross, let us pray to the Lord. That we may recognize the gifts of the Holy Spirit in ourselves and each other, and that we may encourage and use those gifts to extend peace, mercy, and love to those most in need, let us pray to the Lord. For all the children who are being confirmed this weekend, that they are being sealed with the Holy Spirit, and may live fuller, more Christian lives through the gifts of the Holy Spirit. Let us pray to the Lord. For all who have died in Christ, for Emmanuel Mahalas, to whom this Mass is being offered, and for our Mother's Day intentions, let us pray to the Lord.
Heavenly Father, we, your church, ask that once again you send down your Holy Spirit upon us, and that
same Spirit as the church came to birth, opened to all peoples the knowledge of God, and brought together the many languages of the earth in profession of the one faith. Therefore, overcome with pastoral joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they have come.
Praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.